Interesting situation for you on Sunday. It's the first time you're ever going up against the only CFL team you've ever known. What are the thoughts going through your head?
You know what, like I tell everybody, I don't have to play a snap, so, you know, I want them guys to get them prepared and, you know, hope they go out there and give 100%. You know, for me, I'm just going to enjoy the show.
You've been able to, obviously you were there last year with your coach. You were able to maybe help out the defense a little bit this week, give them a little few tips you may have noticed?
I just gave them tips on guys. That was about it, you know. They asked about the different people and how they play, and other than that, you know, offensive-wise, I didn't really, you know, give them nothing that they didn't already know.
Is this something you kind of play backyard football as a kid, pretending you're on Mosaic Stadium grass?
Oh,
now you get to run out here?
Of course. I grew up in Regina. I had season tickets. I was always here cheering on the Riders, and now I'm one of them, so I'm really excited. Yeah.
You're going to be able to sleep Saturday night?
Probably not. I probably won't sleep tonight or tomorrow. Oh yeah, for sure, and my fiance would be in the crowd cheering me on like always, and my family and my friends. It'll be great.
All right, Brendon, the hype of the offseason is about to come to an end here. You finally get to play your first ever game here at Mosaic Stadium. What's going through your head right now?
Just really trying to stay focused on what needs to be done and not get too hyped up with the game still being over 24 hours away. It's tough because you don't want to be, you know, peaking right now. You got to wait until 5 o'clock tomorrow until you're peaking. So it's just a lot of trying to control your emotions, knowing that it's going to be a pretty loud and intense stadium. So I'm definitely looking forward to it. But right now, just trying to stay calm and relax up until game time.
As an offensive line, you guys looked pretty good last week, but you're going up against a much stiffer test in Edmonton, their D-line this week. What do you guys have to improve on?
We just got to be sharper with our calls, and, you know, a lot of it, I mean, we're talking 6 inches different placement with a foot or a step, so it's just honing in on those little things is really going to bring us together, because when you got a big physical group like Edmonton has inside, you know, the slightest little imperfection in any footwork or double team, and they're able to split that, so it's imperative that we have absolutely 100% perfect technique and we work together.
What kind of problems does this Edmonton defense pose?
Well, they're a great defense. They play together and they fly around, and they make it difficult for opposing offenses. So, you know, we just have to make sure we execute our game plan, not try to force it when it's not there, and, you know, just be smart, play smart football, and if we do that, we'll be fine.
You know, they're probably going to be concentrating a lot on Weston tomorrow afternoon. I mean, you got to be a little quicker with your checks than some of your other receivers.
Well, I'm going to just take what the defense gives me. Last week they gave me a lot of opportunities to get Weston the ball, and that's what happened. If they want to take Weston away, we have plays that aren't designed specifically for Weston. So, you know, we just have to make sure that everyone's in the right spot. I go through my reads, and if it goes to dress, then so be it. If not, then, you know, just have to keep moving.
What do you see out of this Saskatchewan defense?
You know, they have a group of guys that play hard. You know, they run to the ball, and they come out with a lot of intensity. So we just have to match their intensity and execute at a high level, and we'll be okay.
You bounced around to a few different teams the last few years. How difficult is it to learn a new offense almost every year?
You know, it's difficult as far as you can learn the offense, but it's the chemistry and timing with the players, I think, that's the most difficult. But, you know, right now I haven't been in a couple situations like that, so I had to kind of adjust to it, and you just have to rely on like basic rules and stuff that you learn from different offense and teams and apply those, but at the same time adjust to your players.
How big of a difference coming into this game against Saskatchewan this year, having to go up against a guy like Odell Willis compared to last year when there wasn't really much of a pass rush?
Well, I played against Odell Willis last year. He was a problem last year. So coming to Saskatchewan last year, I think they got nice pressure on us in Toronto. So I think just their defense in general, you know, these are a lot of talented guys, and they're going to do everything they can to try to confuse the quarterback and get to the quarterback.